Boris Johnson has won the UK election. The Conservative Party delivering a knockout blow to Labour and setting the stage for Britain's exit from the European Union next month. Nine's Europe correspondent Amelia Adams is in London for us tonight. Amelia, an incredible win for the Prime Minister.
Sure is, Mark. His big Brexit gamble has paid off as we go to where the Conservatives have won 362 seats to Labour's 203. So this sets the Tories up for their best election performance since Margaret Thatcher won back in 1987. In the coming hours, we'll see Boris Johnson head to see the Queen, where he'll be asked to form government again so that he can then focus on delivering his key campaign promise, navigating the UK out of the EU by the end of January. But for now, the Conservatives savouring a night they will never forget.
Even Boris Johnson couldn't have imagined it would be this good.
Good evening, everybody. Good evening.
The Conservatives didn't just hold on, they obliterated Labour, an election wipeout few saw coming.
Duly elected.
Thank you, thank you. This One Nation Conservative government has been given a powerful new mandate.
It's a Conservative win.
There will be a Conservative majority when all the votes are counted.
We're seeing seats going from the Labour Party to the Conservative Party, and that is the big theme of the night.
After a brutal five-week campaign, Mr Johnson clearly needed some unconditional love and support. Dylan, the dog from 10 Downing Street, helping the PM cast his vote for someone else, breaking tradition and voting in central London rather than his own marginal seat of Uxbridge and South Ruislip.
Dylan! Dylan!
Opposition leader Jeremy Corbyn gave himself the thumbs up, optimistic after narrowing the gap between the two major parties.
Great victory.
But it was anything but.
I want to also make it clear that I will not lead the party in any future general election campaign.
His stance on Brexit proved his downfall, promising to negotiate a new deal with the EU and hold a second people's vote, and refusing to tell voters whether he'd campaign to leave or remain. Sending the country to the polls just before Christmas was a bold move, but voters defied the cold and the rain to express their deep discontent.
I've always voted Labour all my life, but I will never do it again.
Whether it is out or in, what is important is to have the right things in place.
In the end, the proof was in the pie, or the numbers anyway. The nation choosing the party best placed to see Britain out of the European Union after 46 years. With such a clear majority, Boris Johnson can now, as promised, get Brexit done, or at least get it started. In London, Amelia Adams, Nine News.